All right, in the UK, crypto exchange Binance has been banned in the latest sign of a growing crackdown on the market around the world. To tell us more is Ian Lowe from Dacxi. Ian, good to talk to you again this afternoon. So, yeah, what prompted this ban in the UK for Binance?
Well, just by way of background, Binance is, at least according to CoinMarketCap, the world's most liquid crypto exchange. So in the last 24 hours, just over $15 billion in crypto assets were traded on Binance. Binance is what we call a decentralized exchange. So it's a peer-to-peer exchange. And on that basis, users that trade on that exchange don't need to go through the identification process associated with opening an account, and therefore they operate outside of the AML, the anti-money laundering frameworks that exist around the world. So the thing to keep in mind is that crypto is not properly regulated in the UK and in almost all markets around the world, but other financial instruments such as derivatives and many others are regulated. So essentially what this ban means is that Binance can continue to operate in the UK, but they can't operate a derivatives market because that is a regulated market in the UK. So essentially they're still open for business, but really it only relates to the crypto coins, which is still a substantial part of what trades through that exchange. So if we take a couple of steps back, this is just part of a broader trend where regulation is coming. We're seeing it in the UK. Similar statements around Binance specifically have been made in Japan, in Germany. And so the regulators are moving in. It reflects the growing maturity of the industry. It reflects the growing ownership base of crypto assets. And of course, regulation is good. It protects investors. It helps address issues such as money laundering, and it builds consumer confidence. So the analogy that might be relevant here is as we started to adopt digital media in all its different forms and we started to use it for commerce, we started to understand that data privacy regulations were actually really important. So as an industry, we mobilized, introduced data privacy regulations. Essentially, the crypto industry will need to become an increasingly embedded part of a broader finance ecosystem, and that's what's happening.
Well, of course, you could argue that the regulators are very late to the party. Ian, I'm just wondering then, Binance obviously also available here in Australia. Any indication that regulators here could be taking a look at it?
Well, they are. They are taking a look at it, and they have been for a little while. So when they move and what moves they've put in place remain to be seen. But I think what we can assume is that it's very unlikely that a whole new set of regulatory frameworks will be invented purely for crypto assets. What regulators will look to do in Australia is similar to what we're seeing in other parts of the world, where they will look to bring digital assets in all their different manifestations into the existing regulatory frameworks. And there may be some incremental changes to recognize the unique attributes of digital assets, but by and large, it will really just be about bringing crypto assets into the frameworks that already exist.
Yeah.
So that's what's in store for Australia as well, and it's being looked at right now. There's a Senator Bragg is leading an industry engagement to better understand what sort of regulatory frameworks are going to be helpful.
And meanwhile, that regulation clampdown is continuing in China. Is that still heavily influencing the movement of crypto at the moment?
Look, it certainly had a lingering effect. I think the market has sort of been moving sideways over the last few weeks, due in no small part to what's happened in China. I think as I shared with you previously, it's not a whole bunch of new rules that have been introduced. They're just clamping down on rules that have been in place since 2018. And this is really about paving the way for the introduction of the digital yuan. What we know about that project is it's actually, in many ways, much further progressed than we might have thought. The language of rolling out trials in different parts of China around the digital yuan are actually looking much more like early stage deployment of the digital yuan. So they're they're certainly, you know, leading this move towards central bank digital currencies. And for them, the benefits are really around oversight and all the benefits that come with oversight, particularly around management of wealth and keeping wealth in the country and other benefits. And other countries are moving towards central bank digital currencies. So Japan, the Bank of England has been very active in this area. Sweden, New Zealand recently made an announcement. Australia has a working group on this as well. So what does it all mean? It means that digital money is absolutely coming. It's not something that we can debate if anymore. It's really just about when.
Ian, always good to catch up with the latest in the crypto space. Thanks for joining us from Dacxi.
Good to talk to you.